during the opening time. I'll definitely see you guys before I leave.
Yo, you're touching each other.
Hey, oh, no, it was me. Yeah, it was me. It was me.
Yay!
What's up everyone, Samuel here. Welcome back to another quick video, short video. This is a spontaneous one. I'm going to go outside today to shoot on my Minolta CLE, shooting film, shooting Portra 400. Never shot Portra 400 on this camera, so I'm pretty excited about that. So the reason is actually that I'm going to do a big comparison video between Leica, Fujifilm, Ricoh, Canon and film. Because I want to compare the colors, but for that I need to see if I can shoot Portra on this camera without any problems. So it will be my test roll. And this year I'm actually only shooting black and white, so monochrome only. That was my New Year's resolution. So if you go to my Instagram, everything is black and white. And I'm going to do a big video at the end of this year. I'm talking about what I've learned, my experience. But today I'm going to shoot Portra 400. It's just a test roll. And I wanted to bring my GoPro to vlog a little bit, but it doesn't work anymore. The batteries are not working and I can't even charge the batteries, so nothing works. So no more potato vlogs, but I still have warranty. So on Monday, I'm going to contact GoPro and see if I can get it fixed. At the same time, my GS3 returned. It was being repaired by Ricoh because this little dial here on the back stopped working. But now it's fixed, and I thought, you know, I don't have any small camera at the moment, so maybe I should bring the GR and use that for video. So just to show you how that looks, let's switch it. Okay, so this is how the Ricoh GS3 looks like. It's not really a great video camera, as you can see, but I think it will be enough for today. And yeah, I'm decided to shoot black and white. I mean, record black and white. Looks kind of cool. It has AF. It is a little bit soft, but yeah, should be all right. GS3 vlogging test. So this is how the GS3 looks like when you're vlogging.
Terrible! Hey, terrible. Stop doing that!
And we have a little special guest here.
Hey, hi, Mike.
So, can you do a little introduction maybe?
Sure. Hey, my name's Carlo. I'm from Australia and I've been living in Hamburg for the last 3 years.
How do you find Hamburg for photography, street photography?
Well, I just started street photography here in Hamburg. It can be a little difficult at times, but it's all a learning process, I guess. I mean, I'm sure it's difficult anywhere around the world. It's just a process that I'm doing at the moment. I'm really not good with cameras myself.
No, no problem, man. No problem, man. I gotta ask you, what camera are you using?
I'm using a Nikon Z6 with a 35 1.8 prime. I bought it. I mean, wait, don't scrub that.
What?
Don't tell my wife. Don't tell my wife, bro. She'll kill me.
No worries, I've been there.
He can relate to
it. It took me like six months to tell my wife about this.
That looks new. It's not. It's old. It's
only a different color. I changed the color.
What are you talking about?
Street Alle zwei Superkräfte, die da gerade zuhören. Und jetzt nach draußen. Und sich nicht kriegen, sondern die
Was?
Oh my god, it's Balalaika! Did you watch my stream on Twitch.tv? No? Then you're crazy!
Denn schwarze Leben in Deutschland zählen immer noch nicht. Deutschland fußt auf einer langen Tradition von Straflosigkeit für rechte, rassistische und koloniale Verbrechen. A justice that is not able to judge the obvious injustice that happened in this case of William Tonobobda. In this case, what kind of justice is that?
Get active yourself, demand justice at the public prosecutor's office, in the media, in the schools, at the UKE.
GS3 vlog update. So we just went to a protest that were protesting someone who...
What was the story again? Sorry, I forgot.
Oh, there's a terrible story happening, or happened last year in April 2019. There was a guy, a black guy, who went to the hospital because he wanted some help. Mm. Then they said, you're mental. They wanted to force him to go into the psychiatry. Yeah. He wanted to refuse. They forced him, and the security guy strapped him or restrained him in a way so that he died. Mm. And now they just officially announced that this case is closed and the guy who killed the other guy just runs free. And no one talked to the family. So this is why
The family members?
Yeah, the family members were also there and they are saying that no one has talked to them for a year now. And they are very angry because, yeah, they say that the police and courts in Germany have just proven that black lives don't matter. So they are very angry.
And yeah, and they're going to protest again end of August.
Yes, this is just an announcement and they're going to go and have a real protest on the 30th of August.
Right. B-roll. I need B-roll.
No look.
Das bedeutet, verschränkt mit eure Arme, haltet euch nicht fest, wehrt euch nicht, wenn die Polizei kommen würde, sondern ich habe so ein Bild vor mir. Politische Entscheidungen.
Geht ganz nah an die Dings.
So. Leute, ihr haltet die Abstände nicht ein hier. So. Und das schon die ganze Zeit. Das ist langsam ein bisschen auffällig hier. Sie provoziert das gerade ein bisschen.
Nein, also, wir wollen keinen Stress. Wir machen es ganz
wir können unserer Hamburger Polizei so vertrauen.
Das ist der Kern, Schwörungstheoretiker, sag einfach her, ins Recht und da geht nichts mehr. Sie befassen sich nicht, der Meinung ist, es ist alles gut, es gibt keinen Grund, auf der Ruhe zu sein.
Not focusing. Okay. Yeah. I have very colorful ice cream, but I'm recording in black and white, so. And he has very intensive chocolate.
And I'm breaking the rules. I have a ice in the waffle, but I'm eating it with a spoon.
No, you can't do that.
Ooh, rebel.
And you do like the glasses, the Bud Light. It's the one and only Digo Double G. Of the people. And then went outside to the Antifa. So they thought I was one of them. If I'm one of them, I'm just asking.
just joined the Nazis, which is even worse.
Oh, come on.
This has been an absolutely amazing time, man. Yeah.
I'll definitely see you guys before I leave.
Yo, you're touching each other.
Hey, oh, no, it wasn't me. No, it wasn't me. No, no, it wasn't me.
Okay, microphone check. Rico 3, GR3. So this is the end of this video. It was a pretty packed day. We didn't expect to see this huge protest again. So, what are we going to talk about?
We had a magic moment.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So the protest ended peacefully. And there were these the Antifa guys again. But this time we talked to them and made sure they understand that we are, you know, neither on their side nor on the other side. We're trying to document it. And then they were like, yeah, but like...
They were asking, you have to be on one side.
Yeah, yeah.
What is your side? Where are you standing and everything like that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so they accepted us as witnesses of what's happening and photographers. It led to us being some kind of middleman in between, you know, the anti-corona protesters and the Antifa guys. And suddenly, like, a few of these anti-corona protesters came, and then they started to have a little discussion. It was like a friendly discussion.
But a good discussion. They didn't shout at each other.
Yeah.
They listened and talked.
And that went on for at least 1 hour. And they sat down on the ground and they had a conversation.
They were shaking hands.
I mean, some of them, very peaceful. And at the end, both were saying thank you to us. Not only us, but also us, because we kind of started it. And saying this was really good, like having a discussion. But this is something that can never happen on a big protest. It needs to happen in small groups of people. So
yeah.
But it was very, very good.
It felt good. It actually felt as if we finally did something good. Before, we were just only documenting.
Mm.
And since we've been documenting so long, we had arguments, we had points, like valid for both sides. Like, we saw this. But do you agree that this is correct? Do you agree that that is correct? And now they both kind of understood each other a little better.
Mm.
Not fully, but it was one step in the right direction. So I am proud of myself today, honestly.
No. And
whatever anybody might say in the comments here,
no.
This is for you.
In my eyes, I always saw the Antifa guys as very aggressive.
Yeah.
And of course there are aggressive people amongst them, but the ones we talked today, They were just calm and peaceful, and they didn't want any, you know,
conflict. The interesting thing today, because in my stream we also had this debate, and then on your stream as well with this journalism student. So today I thought to myself, you know what, I'm going to try a different approach. And I went and approached the Antifa differently and very friendly and openly, like, hey, this is what I'm doing. I'm trying to do something good and everything. And it worked. So I have to say, it is all based on the approach. If the media guys go to the Antifa in a specific manner, then they will protest against it in a very aggressive way. But if you, you know, talk to them, they actually are people who listen to you and have, like, good hearts.
Yeah, I think that just shows you that it's all about, you know, talking face to face about issues. If you are inside a group, then it's hard to, you know, talk outside of your group because you're in this group. You don't want to.
You don't want to be a traitor of your group.
And because there were just three, it was three or four of them, so they felt more. They felt safer to really say what they think, and even accept to talk to, you know, the other protesters and us. So I guess what's the lesson we learned in this video?
It was a very peaceful thing. We can make it peaceful. It doesn't have to be aggressive. And, you know, listening is the key. Listening, not speaking.
But this was supposed to be a little vlog about me shooting Portra 400 on this camera. But it ended up being another protest video, so sorry if this bores you, but this is what's happening.
I even forgot that you told me about it, but I even forgot. To me, it was all day.
We just met today because we wanted to see what's happening in the city. We didn't even know that this big protest is
going to
happen.
I wanted to go to this Black Lives Matter protest, which was important to me, obviously, but And then we ran into this, and he was like, didn't you see, we spoke on the phone, and I'm like, yeah, I'm close to the town center, do you want to meet here? And he was like, no, haven't you seen what's going on at Jungfernstieg? And I was like, no. And he said, just come here, you'll see.
Yeah. I don't know what to say.
Just say bye, put your hand on the lens and be happy.
Okay. this was just another slice of life of Samuel Street Life.
Oh,
that rhymes! to be continued.
Für mich war das heute wirklich ein guter Tag. Wirklich, wow.
Okay, and by the way, how did you find the Ricoh GS3 footage? I think this is the new potato vlog. The GoPro is too good.
Yeah, right?
This is the new potato vlog. No, I have to fix my GoPro.
He's always nitpicking. He loves quality so much that he can't really give you a real potato vlog. But maybe this one will be one.
Going to give you the honor to do the hand thing.
Oh, okay. Who am I?
Are we done now?
What is this lame-ass shit? I'm not jumping,
hey,
rope
this
jumping.
This is Hammer's jumping rope.